Hey everyone, it's Mark Sargent, and this is Flat Earth Q&A Email 17. And everybody knows the drill by now, so let's just get right to it. First email is from TC in Vermont. He writes, "Hi Mark, again. If world leaders are going to Antarctica to speak with, let's call them the dome prefects or aliens, then what does this say about the character of these Martians? That they would allow the continuance over millennia of the oppression and brutality of man towards his fellow humans. I don't think I like these space travelers. Thanks, TC in Vermont." And yeah, TC, this is something I've addressed a few times, but it's one of the oldest questions that people have come up with if they ever met God face to face, which is, why do you let, and I know I'm going to butcher it a little bit, why do you let good things happen to bad people? And a couple things. I don't believe necessarily in space travelers because I don't necessarily think there's space. Martians probably shouldn't use that word because Mars and Venus and Saturn, I don't think anyone lives on those bodies. Do I think there are realms outside of this one? Yes, I do. Do I think there's other enclosed worlds outside of this one? Yes, I do. When it comes to why bad things happen to good people, though, a couple different ways you could look at it. One, you could look at it from a system standpoint and say that if bad things didn't happen to good people, then everyone would be good. Does that sound too simple? So what I mean is you don't want to ever leave an exploit in a system like this. You don't want to say that give people the like, if you help 10 ladies across the street, you know, in a crosswalk, then you automatically find a bag of money with $1,000 in it. That again, sounds too simple, but that's one way to look at it because you don't ever want to make anything absolute. There's got to be some sort of variance in here. But the one I really go to, at least personally, this is the one I subscribe to, is that are bad things really happening to a lot of people here because of the evil of man or because we also maybe volunteered for it? Meaning God's kind of off the hook if you ask to come in here. If this is a ride, if this is a movie, if this is a sound stage, if this is a video game, a simulation, whatever you want to call it, then chances are you volunteered for it. You paid your ticket. You had plenty of chances. Anyone has any doubts about that? Look at some of the tracing boards from the Masonics. There's only five of them out there, and it certainly shows what appears to be the instructions on how to get into a ride, not to steal too much from Bill Hicks, but that's what I subscribe to. So bad things happening in the world, yes, there is, but I think this world was absolutely designed that way, and I think that people here, including myself, volunteered for it. And if you sign in the dotted line, if you pay your ticket, I use the roller coaster example, which is everyone, you know, you go to roller coasters, but not a lot of people are, you know, laughing and giggling while they're on roller coasters. It can be really, really scary. You know, roller coasters are meant to thrill you. But at the same time, we know it's a roller coaster, right? Thing is, what I'm getting at is you pay your ticket. You know, you buy your ticket, then you get in line, you have every chance to turn around and not go on that roller coaster. Yeah, of course you have peer pressure from your friends, but eventually you get on the roller coaster and then you get scared to death. And when you get off, it's like, oh, I'm never doing that again. And sure enough, once it wears off, you're going back at it again. So that's kind of the long version of a way around on this one, but that's the one that I subscribe to. Other people may have a different version of why bad things happen on this world, but I do believe, and I wrote a paper on this some years ago, I don't have it anymore, it was called Static World Theory, which is, this world is perfect conflict. I quote Joe Walsh when he was talking about the life of a rock star. I can't complain, but sometimes I still do. Conflict is unavoidable here. It's inescapable, inevitable, as it were. So, anyway. Thank you very much, TC in Vermont. Dom writes, "Dear Mark, feel free to use my name. My name is Dominic, and I am a graphic designer by trade. I have listened to most of your shows, including Globusters and The Secret Shows with Patricia. I'm putting together a flatter section on my upcoming store and would love your input. I have heard you say on a few shows that That should be on a t-shirt with regards to a few quotes or flat earth sayings. Yeah, I did it even last night. What would you consider to be the top 5, 10 quotes that go onto t-shirts, mugs, hoodies, phone cases, etc.? I would love it if you could possibly give me some input, or maybe also give out this email address live on your show so people could also contact me with their own good flat earth quotes to be considered for inclusion in my flat earth section on the forthcoming store. Thanks, Mark Dominic. All right, I'm going to give out his email address. I'm not going to give out that many quotes because I'd have to do some research on it for my top 10. His email address is thedictatorhuntsyou1983@gmail.com. So thedictatorhuntsyou1983@gmail.com. The one that probably is on a t-shirt already, probably my favorite, which is, I think, one of the themes for the movement slash community, is that I became a flat earther because I tried to debunk flat earth, or something to that effect. DITRH probably does a better version than that, but that's the big one. That is, nobody becomes a flat, there's so many quotes out there, but nobody becomes a flat earther by choice. We are all roped into it. We all try to debunk flat earth, and then we become flat earthers. So hopefully that helps, and hopefully you get some quotes from people out there. And again, look at some of the memes that are in my slideshows for Strange World or the Q&A sessions. Like today, there's a whole bunch of memes out there, you know, pick and choose. There's tons out there you can go with. But thank you, Dominic. Let's see. This one's titled The Magic Show, and it's by Love Spirit. No name. I recently had an experience happen causing me to remember many things from when I was a child. I would like to know more about this magic show you refer to, along with Creative Forces situation. If that's at all possible, not to sound so upfront, I can assure you I'm very polite and like a child in many ways, so I wouldn't judge or mistreat you in any way. Oh, that's awfully nice. When you first came about, I was watching your videos, but I haven't watched them in the last couple of years. I would have to say, last couple of years? They've only been out the last couple of years. So I recently came across your channel again and felt like now, based the paragraph in the info section, you may have something more to offer me. Can't really trust anybody because the dark side are looking to devour. I feel I'm still slightly disconnected because of various life choices, but I'm working on them right now, so this is why I seek, even though I have already found. To just have an intellectual conversation with somebody who may know what I'm talking about would really just brighten my life and let me know I'm not by myself. Maybe there are other patterns that I have missed. Maybe there's something down my path that might be able to assist me in the now. So can you tell me about this magic show in the wheels, in the pinwheels, and the stars, and the sparkles, and the swirls, and the glitter, and the love? What you know of these things. Thank you for taking your time to read this. I hope to hear from you sincerely, Jennifer. And I missed her name initially because she kind of built it all into one paragraph. Thank you, Jennifer. And I just go out there and type in flat earth into YouTube and just start absorbing more material. There's a lot of stuff out there and a lot of people talking about it. This one's from Ashley Kinsley. Oops, probably shouldn't have said her last name, but it's Ashley from Georgia. And she said, look what came today. When I'm finished reading, even though I watched the clues, it's going to be in my powder room or guest bathroom. And she bought a copy of the Flat Earth Clues book. And she included a picture of her holding it. So I am going to, anyone wants to have themselves on camera in the slideshow, please take a selfie with you in the book. Of course, you get to buy the book. And then send it to me. I'm sorry, that's if you want it autographed. But send me the pic of you with the book, and I will include it in the slideshow and, you know, like the license plates. So cool. Thank you, Ashley. It's wonderful. Moving on. Joseph. Oh, here's the guy that tried to debunk the flat earth a while ago. I'm going to read this email. I'm not going to really answer a whole bunch of his questions. I'll answer some during the email. But this is from Joseph Markle. He was the guy that tried to debunk flat earth in the big long email. And by the time I got to the end, you could realize that he wasn't really a scientist, but a very spiritual religious man who was having a real tough time letting go of the solar system. So don't hate on him too much. Mr. Sargent, was surprised my email was used in part of your talk show. I guess a real radio talk show? Yes. Near Seattle, Washington? Yes. I listened about an hour. We'll listen to the rest later. But my comments about weather patterns on North and Southern Hemisphere are hard to understand with a flat earth model. Question mark. Maybe you were doing, yeah, puts a lot of question marks where I don't think there should be. Maybe you were doing all this as a study to learn just how many people could be fooled. No. How far can it go? Very far. Fake news? No. Such a notion suggests a contrived earth, artificial, made by who for what purpose? I do believe in a Christian creator God, but his methods of creation involve an entire universe and everything in it more or less derivative from a creative act. The Bible does not discuss a flat earth, but creation on a massive scale is in Genesis. Much of it correlates with the Big Bang theory, generally. If you want to have some fun there, and hopefully you're listening to this, check out Rob Skiba's wonderful website, testingtheglobe.com, which is made more or less for Christians, but you should really look into it, because if you are a Christian and you believe in the globe earth, you've got to revisit a whole bunch of stuff. I studied life of Tesla. He disagreed with Einstein, true, did not believe space could be curved, etc., had his own dynamic theory of gravity. He also said the earth wasn't a planet, by the way. It was a realm. That's my words, not his. Tesla had done many experiments with serious electricity, dangerous voltages, and was in many accidents. I suspect it damaged his brain as he aged. He developed obsessive compulsive habits, very disturbing. He had few friends, lived on the 33rd floor of a hotel in New Yorker, so his late life work might have been more the result of illness. Well, I think that's a stretch. His early work was phenomenal. I don't recall any mention Tesla thought the earth was flat. Look again, it is out there. In fact, I mentioned it on the show last night. Oh, on Strange World. Oh, many experiments done on Earth as to gravity. It varies slightly from place to place because Earth is pear-shaped from rotating on its axis so long, irregular sphere. Fantastic. Glad you said that it was pear-shaped and an irregular sphere. Find me a picture of the Earth that shows it anything but an absolutely pixel-perfect sphere. Find me one of those, please. Mass produces gravity. True mass, not gas mass like Jupiter or Saturn. The rate of objects falling is uniform, proved by Isaac Newton long ago. And the same experiment done on the moon by the astronauts. Vacuum on the moon's surface. You believe in NASA too. Oh, and then he goes down this road. And all the probes to Mars and beyond by NASA since the 1960s. No dome encountered. You know, says NASA. The trouble to hoax all that is incredible. Not at all, really. It's very, very few people have to know about this. Planets orbit the sun because it's the largest massive object and its gravity attracts the most. So it is the relative center, but there might be a red dwarf star on the elliptical orbit, Nibiru myth, which if it's true, might affect the solar system every 3,000 years or so. I got to cut in because I love this. This shows you how great the conditioning is. Not only does he believe in the solar system, but he absolutely believes in Nibiru, you know, Planet X, but he still dismisses the flat Earth. So, you know, all other conspiracies will fit in, you know, and everyone has no other problem with other conspiracies. Bigfoot could have Elvis Presley's baby, but that would be perfectly acceptable to some people. But flat Earth is initially accepted by no one, all right? Are you part of some experiment to see how many people can be fooled? You're kind of talking about what you did in the very first paragraph. No, I'm not. Seems fishy? Not at all. Do you think Earth is better as flat? I think it's better flat or disc-shaped. Flat and disc-shaped, yes, both, same thing. Or totally contrived in the way you believe. Totally contrived? No idea where you're going. I believe it's flat and disc-shaped. Also, there might be permanent temperature inversions above water horizons, which distort the density of atmosphere thicker at horizon perception. Chicago case was on the Weather Channel a few months ago from Grand Rapids, but skyline dissipated as air mass moved. Yeah. I've got a 12-hour time lapse of Chicago skyline from the beach. Does not move. Weather goes over it. It rains. It gets dark. Nothing wavers. You should ask Michio Kaku to comment on your evidence. Yes, and please, I want to talk to a scientist. I do want to talk to him, but he's so far gone. There's nothing we can do for him. He is a modern Einstein. Oh, wow. Co-founder of string theory, he knows. Do you like the idea of flat Earth? Yes, I do. Does it appeal to you? Yes, I do. If true, and I doubt it, why would you doubt it? It completely upsets all we know about space-time. Yes, that's the point. Who or what would have made a flat Earth? Why? Okay, if you believe in God and God made the solar system, why would it be such a stretch for God to make a flat, enclosed world? It's not. In fact, it's so much easier and so much more efficient. you're only quoting the solar system because you were conditioned, because science told you there was a solar system. Religion didn't tell you there was a solar system. Science did. Okay? This is probably more about you. Unfulfilled, frustrated, wanting attention. No. Maybe you get a kick out of all this. Yes? No. Thanks for attention, J.G. Markle. I'm hoping that JG listened to some of this, and I'm not going to even tell him, I'm not going to write him back and tell him that I did this on this show. He can just listen to it, but I'm probably not going to read any more of his emails, because he is, who knows, he may turn eventually. He may come around to the flat earth, but I don't think it's going to be anytime soon. He's holding on to the solar system way too tight, which is weird, because he's holding on to the solar system and religion simultaneously. Because what, there's all sorts of quotes in the Bible that says that the earth is, that the world is a solar system? Don't think so. Next email from Andrew. Hey man, I just came across this and was wondering your thoughts. Haven't heard anyone discussing this yet on Flat Earth. Thanks, peace, keep up the good work. And it's the poll to poll thing at mikehorn.com. Are they actually gonna do it? A video on this would be interesting maybe. Hopefully this guy doesn't die. Or if he finds something interesting, we'll get the truth about it. Yeah, if, you know, people have talked about doing a pole-to-pole circumnavigation for quite some time. No one's done it yet, so find me a video when they actually finish it. Until then, I'm not going to even address it. You know, people can talk about it all they want. Until you actually get me someone that can show me unedited video, then I'm not gonna touch it. Mark Parker writes, totally on board. Hey, Mark, my name is also Mark. I am from the UK. I have been listening to you and others since pretty much the beginning, and I totally get it. I try to explain it to people, and it is like you say, you have to choose carefully who you talk to, and it's a good idea to test the water first. My wife knows, but she gets tired of me talking about it, but I think it frightens her to know the reality of things, but I also talk to my kids about it, as I want them to be aware of the deception too. People try to debunk me when I say it, but it's the simple things like, why don't we fall off the edge? Yeah, I know, that's my favorite horrible one. I tell them I really don't have time to explain things so simple. Agreed. And they need to do some research before they try to debunk anything. But again, I think it frightens people. My hope is that I am planting some kind of seed in their mind, and they are secretly looking at this, and they will do the same to their friends and so on. I had a discussion with my brother-in-law just yesterday, and he was saying, but we can use the ISS straight away. I'm thinking, oh, here we go again. And then I am saying things like, but how do you know that is what they say it is, and it is as far as they say it is? All I got was rolling eyes and silence, but again, a seed was possibly planted. Love what you are doing, Mark, along with Jaron and the others. They know who they are. Keep it going, and we all know this is not going away ever. Mark. Thanks, Mark, and you're absolutely right. It is not going away. And you know, perfect example what he said there. Be careful who you talk to about this. Size them up first. Do not create enemies if you don't have to. If you've got someone that's really against all of this, you don't want to put them in a position where they are now going to be hostile towards you. Don't do it. Just be gentle about it. Treat it like Fight Club. Fight Club, the rule, first rule of Fight Club is you do not talk about Fight Club. But that is also to say that wasn't the absolute rule. Everybody knows you're going to talk about Fight Club. But the point was, you show restraint. Don't just start blabbing about it to everybody. Pick your targets. This one is from who? Matthias. Hi, Mark. It's been a few months since I emailed you. I'm a little less paranoid about who is a shill and who's not now. I guess I realized it really doesn't matter. I was thinking recently, and I had an idea that my small intellect couldn't figure out, but I wanted to bounce it off you. I have spent my nights mostly paying attention to the moon and Venus and other bodies. My days peeking over the horizon too far, of course, and a thought came to me. With a few exceptions, the globular model just works with almost every observation I can make. Indeed, both models work almost perfectly all the time, and I've noticed this from the very beginning and marveled at it as the brilliance of their lie. But then it hit me, the only way the globular model could be so observably correct is if they knew and understood the flat earth system and made some conversion, rotary to spherical, or some such conversion. It seems to me that it should follow that this conversion could be reversed to give us an accurate flat earth model. I don't know how to make such a conversion. Math was never my strong suit, but this makes sense to me. Thoughts? Again, people are working on it right now, the revision of the map to try to get it to where the perspective and the ratios are all something that we can all agree on. Everyone's working on it right now, or several people are working on it. But I don't have any other advice to give you there. It's being formed, but right now it's in progress. So thanks though. Paddy, P-A-D-D-Y. I've never known of someone named Paddy. Paddy writes, "Hi, Mark. Just listening to a podcast with you, and I am amazed the level of false information." Oh, love it. Troll email. Let's read it. "False information. You continue to repeat. Antarctica is not off limits. With enough money, I could book a holiday right now to Antarctica. That is not the only one. There is a live video stream from the ISS 24/7. Regards, Paddy." And I don't know where Paddy is from. Real name's Patrick Healy, from superdesigns.com. Paddy, these are too easy. One, I never said that Antarctica was off limits to people. In fact, I said that in the clue. I said, you want to book a flight to Antarctica, go ahead. It'll cost you $10,000 to $15,000. You're going to have your picture taken with penguins on the peninsula somewhere. No corporation, however, your corporation, Super Designs, for example, could not go down there and do work officially. It doesn't matter how much money you have, doesn't matter how many people you bribe, you cannot go there. No countries, corporations can go to Antarctica. And as far as, you know, there's a live video stream from the ISS 24/7. Yes, thank you for putting more faith in NASA. If you believe that the ISS stream 24/7 is real, then you also believe that the moon missions are real. And man, you got problems if the moon missions are a reality to you, because they have aged horribly over the years. So anyway, these are common questions I get, but thanks. You know, I rarely get troll emails, but if I do get them and they're, you know, somewhat coherent, not drunk, written at 3 o'clock in the morning with horrible punctuation and spelling and grammar, I will read them. So thanks, Patty. Anthony writes, Mark, I have some questions. I'm new to all this. One, is the sun smaller than our flat earth? Yes. Two, is the sun, moon, and stars all contained inside the firmament? Maybe. So is the sun smaller than flat earth? Yes, has to be. The sun could be only, you know, less than 50 miles wide. And same thing with the moon. Is the sun, moon, and stars all contained inside the firmament? The stars might be in the firmament. The sun and the moon might be under the underside and might be above it. It's tough. I think even the Book of Enoch really doesn't specify whether it is above or below the superstructure. So maybe, but good questions. Thank you very much for that. Moving on, conspiracy music for you. Hello, Mark. My name is Al Riley, and I'm a huge fan of your work. I would love to offer my entire catalog of music and music videos to use free of charge, however you would like. I have many songs and videos which are conspiracy truth oriented, and I sincerely believe you will find something you would like to use, but you are also free to utilize any of my other material as well. I hope that my creative efforts can assist you in getting your message out to the people. Thanks in advance for your time, and keep doing what you do. My music videos are available here on YouTube, and the songs themselves are free to download on SoundCloud under the name Empty Music. There's a whole lot of dots there. From Al Riley. Thank you. And I will check them out when I get a chance. Matthew writes, hello, my name is Matthew. My story about coming to term with this plane we live on is similar to everyone else. I poo-pooed it at first, but then on December 6th, my babysitter had a family thing, so I got to spend the day with my boys. Well, they took a nap, and I was looking into Nephilim videos, and a video popped up, and in the title it said, "Don't scoff, just watch." So I did, and my boys took a super long nap, and I watched a lot of videos, and it just clicked. So now I have the social struggle, which brings me to the subject, the why. My wife is awesome and entertains the conversation, but I'm not good at conveying what's going on in my head. Her biggest reservation is, why would they lie in the first place? What did they have to gain in the first place? My reasoning is complicated in my head, but the simple version is that it was that was being taught, or they had two choices at the time. Continue on and remain in control, or tell the truth and all that entails. I'm just not sure if there is a better way to approach this to her. No. No, there isn't. And the whole control issue, I talked about that in The Clue, is status quo. You know, check it out. You know, watch it again. There's other people that have touched on it a little bit, but I do think the clues were as easy as it's going to get. For a lot of people, it's like, why would they hide it? Why would they hide it? It's like, I explained it in some detail in The Clues. Look, everything would collapse, or potential to collapse. The academic system, the economic system, spirituality, everything would be overturned, and even though I do think we'd come out the other side, there'd be a lot of chaos, and the powers that be, they just don't want to deal with it. So hopefully that helps a little bit. Just revisit The Clues. This one is from, best regards, who's it from? Don't know. Test it. Best regards, no name. I find your point of view very interesting, but I have some questions. Why do we see the moon with the naked eye like a circle that is vertical shifted and not like a circle that is laid on top of the earth? Do I make myself understand? That's verbatim. If the earth is flat and also flat moon is circling above it, then we should see the moon like a circle laid on top of the earth and not like a disc in a vertical manner. And again, I'm going to use the planetarium argument. When you go to a planetarium, does the moon look really good? Yes, it does. How did they do it? They altered the image to where it would fit on that ceiling just perfect. Why wouldn't the people that built this place do the same sort of thing? So don't, again, go to a planetarium sometime. In fact, I've got to revisit one. I haven't been to one in years. Go to a planetarium. Look up in the sky. It'll make, sorry, I say sky, but it's actually the ceiling. Go in there and tell me what you think, because it will answer a lot of questions for you. Two, and how do you explain the fact that a ship looks like it's sinking in the water when crossing the horizon of the ocean? Go into YouTube, type in flat earth boat or flat earth boat horizon and look up the videos for that. Jaren's probably got one of the best ones out there right now from Jarenism, and that will answer that question. Three, if the sun is always circling the earth in the same manner, why do we experience different temperatures at different centuries? Experience that winter is shorter, summer is shorter, and so on. Different temperatures at different centuries? Who knows what sort of clock system they've got the sun running on and what the temperatures. They're not going to have the same temperatures every year. That's the whole point. Not only are you going to have seasons, but you're going to have hot seasons and cold seasons. It's like, oh, it was the coldest winter ever. It was the hottest five summers of all time. It's part of the building process. Let me see here. Man, if you could help me with these things, I would be really impressed. Thank you very much. I'm sorry for my spelling. English is not my mother language. Shocker there. And I don't really have a name for him, but his English is not his main language. So hopefully he was listening and hopefully he got something out of that. John Norman writes, hey, my name is John Norman. I hope you get a chance to read my email. I started to listen to you about a year ago. I caught on to the flat earth theory instantly. I remembered all the times I got to fly and I never saw a curve. Everything always seemed flat. Because of my schedule, I don't get to hear you on YouTube as much as I used to. I am one of your subscribers. I have 5.5 questions. That's original. You may have covered my questions on your show. One, I believe there's a firmament. My question, doing your research, do you think there's a doorway or portal out of the earth? Yes, I do. I do think there's a doorway or portal, maybe multiple ones. Do I think we can access them? No, I don't. Two, do you think the creator or creators created the other earth worlds? Don't know. Won't know until they get out and actually see the other earth worlds. Three, do you think the so-called aliens seen by some on this planet are part of this planet's inhabitants, and as a result, they have always been here along with us? Or do you think they come through a portal, a door, way into this planet? I think most of them are here with us, if not all. I think very few are outside of this place. Look up the 1561 Nuremberg event, where there were at least three factions of ships. Two of them were duking it out, and then a third faction, which took a whole hour to get there with a single black ship. The others had multiple ships. They were the ones that scared them away. You know, who were those guys? Was the black ship outside, or were the other ships inside? I do think there are some groups that are trapped in here with us. Yeah, I suppose you could call them aliens. But we normally associate aliens with other planets. I just think they're older civilizations. Number four, do you think it is all possible to go to the moon? No, I do not. Or do you think it has some type of force field that keeps us away? Worse than that, I don't think you can land on the moon. I think it's tiny, and I don't think, even if you land, and who knows what the gravity effect is when you get up there, if it's even a real solid object. If it is, then no. Bottom line, you can't get there. What do you think is beyond the firmament? Possible space, heaven, and space. I think it's an unlimited dimension. It's the exact opposite of this place. If this place is a completely conflicted dimension, meaning there's nothing but conflict and strife, and that it's something you can't escape, it no matter how rich, how powerful, how beautiful, how talented you are, you can't escape the conflict of this world. Can't complain, but sometimes I still do. Everybody has something to complain about. Then I think the outside of this place is the opposite of that. I think it's complete freedom and unlimited imagination power. Sorry for all the questions, but I love this topic. It has such mysteries. Yes, which is why everybody likes it too. Thanks, John Norman from Birmingham, Alabama. Roll Tide. I think they're going to win the national championship again, but that's because it's the only sports team really in the state. This one's from Shannon. I was listening to Pastor David Anderson's on YouTube trying to debunk the flat earth, and for literally 13 minutes he did nothing but put down the people who believe in it and did nothing to debunk it. I'm so disheartened by the Christian community on YouTube not being open to the possibility that we've been lied to, and the Bible clearly says that Satan is the father of lies and he'll deceive us with signs and lying wonders. Oh my God. When is there going to be a mainstream pastor coming out in support of what the Bible clearly is, a flat earth book? Mark, I'm getting to the point where I'm getting so mad I can't even listen to normal preaching anymore. Shannon, you're absolutely right, Shannon. There should be more people that comes up. But like a lot of people that I've interviewed with over the last couple of years and the other people I've talked to, look, they're afraid of losing members. They're afraid of losing subscriptions. They're afraid of losing some of their congregation. You bring up Flat Earth in a church service, there's a chance that some people are going to get up and walk out. Now, granted, they're going to be small-minded people they're not ready. They're not ready to open up their minds to it. But that's the fear. You know, you're really willing to let people walk out the door, out the church doors? A lot of people aren't. And that's what stops them. Look at Kent Hovind. He believes literally, he's a Bible literalist. But it doesn't matter how many examples, again, using testingtheglobe.com, Rob Skiba, doesn't know how many examples are out there. He doesn't want to look at it because he's afraid of losing his following. Men do not like giving up power. Moving on. This one's from Trev. Hi, boss. I'm from England, new to Flat Earth. Why are they lying to us? How does it affect me? And what can I do? It's mind-blowing. I'm 53, a free thinker, and have lots of my own theories. But what is your suggestion on keeping ahead of the game? The Reverend T-Bone. His actual name is Trev Smith, I think. Staying ahead of the game, just look, spreading the word, but spread it cautiously and, drop. All you have to do is put seeds in people's heads. That's all you have to do. You do not have to convince people that the earth is flat. Just put the seed in their head. Because like them, you were like this. You were against Flat Earth. I was against Flat Earth. I didn't wake up one day and thought that Flat Earth was the greatest idea since sliced bread. I thought it was a horrible idea. And everyone that tries to disprove it gets sucked in, and that's all you have to do. Have somebody try to disprove it. Get them mad if you want, but don't get them mad at you. Put the frustration in their head and say, yeah, this Flat Earth thing's stupid, right? I couldn't disprove it, could you? And that's how people start. It's, oh yeah, well, you're an idiot. You couldn't disprove it. I, however, am intelligent. I should be able to shut down Flat Earth. And yet, no scientist has come forward trying to shut this thing down because there's too many questions they can't answer. This one's from Jeff. Hi, Mark. I'm a Flat Earther. Now, thanks to you, you are the coolest. Wow, that was one of the first time ever somebody said that I was the coolest. I listen to you every day and whoever else comes up. I'm convincing people about the flat earth. They look at me crazy, but once I start talking about it and they're kind of like, wow, then they check into another flat earther. Jeff La Fortune in Minnesota. Thanks, Jeff. And yeah, keep spreading the word. Awesome. This one's from Dean. Hi, Mark. Interesting video on YouTube, and I am especially interested in contacting the producers who are planning the Antarctica mission. I am a filmmaker who might be of service. Sincerely, Dean. Hope you find somebody. Whoever's going to Antarctica, good luck. I don't know if you're going to be allowed to circumnavigate it. There may be some delays. There may be some technical problems. There could be some tragedy. Be careful if you're thinking about going to Antarctica. That's all I'm saying. There's better ways of trying to prove this place rather than going into Antarctica. Again, remember, Admiral Byrd spent the better part of 30 years down there looking with a plane, and he was the world's greatest explorer. So, tall order if you think you're going to be able to do it in a couple-week period. This one's from Ted. How does Planet X fit into the Flat Earth model? Hey, Mark, I've enjoyed your clues, and I'm very much interested in the Flat Earth model. Also, I've been following the Planet X work of Marshall Masters. I found that you were on a coast-to-coast show on October of 2015. Actually, I think it was earlier in 2015, October. I think it was May. 2015, following Marshall Masters, I think, it's because you were listening to a rerun, and I hope that you would touch on your idea of how Planet X fits into the Flat Earth model, but you did not. Have you thought about this, and what do you think? Thanks, Ted. The Planet X, I used to be a believer in Planet X. Used to, in fact, I boosted my prep supplies because of Planet X back in 2012. But then, once I got into Flat Earth, I realized that Planet X would just be yet another simulation, another con. So if, and I've told people this on several things, if you see Planet X in the sky or mainstream media starts talking about Planet X, whatever you see in the sky, do not be afraid that it's the end of the world. It's just going to be a wonderful light show. Yeah, there might be some explosions here and there, but it's not going to run into the world. This world has gone through many iterations, and Planet X is just another part of the storyline. A pretty clever part of the storyline, because they've gone back years on dropping the breadcrumbs for this one. But again, what happened in 2012? Planet X, it's 2017 right now. 2017, where is it? If it comes now, it's going to be like the sequel that was way overdue. How many Hollywood movies can I use? We'll just pick one. Zoolander 2. That movie took way... If you could have come out with Zoolander 2 like 2 years after the first one, you would have been fine. It waited way too long. And there's many... You look that up on online. How many Hollywood sequels that took way too long to do. So anyway, thank you, Ted. This one's from Brad. Brad says, hi, Mark. I've been a geocentrist for many years before I took a look at flat earth topics. The Bible has always described the earth as immovable and the sun as a moving body, unless God decided to stop it. Joshua 10. I know that one. Even though it was a huge leap to click on that first video, I know what he's talking about there, of some nutter that thought we did not live on a spinning pear. The material I found from folks that actually use the scientific method convinced me that there is no proof for the heliocentric model. Once I toured your flat earth clues, I was hooked. I have immersed myself in it for over a year and a half. I still marvel every time I go outside and look at the day and the night sky. As devilish as it was for the globers to deceive us, it has been the most wonderful and marvelous blessing to glimpse the truth. I can see how this can be used to interest atheists and agnostics in the Bible, which has contained these truths for thousands of years. I drive a taxi in Albuquerque and try to take every opportunity I can to garner some interest in the flat earth. What a great feeling when someone calls me a few weeks later, as excited as I am about the enclosed world that was created especially for us. By the way, has anyone spliced together a clip of Tattoo from Fantasy Island saying, the plane. Yeah, actually, there's been a few people that said that. With a clip from 100,000 feet up in the horizon. Oh, that's actually pretty good. I think that would make a nice intro for somebody. Regards, Brad from ABQ Taxi. Thank you, Brad. Very positive email. Love keeping it positive. Mark T writes, got my New York plates. And if you don't know what we're talking about, because my YouTube channel has my license plate from Washington State, which says it's flat because you get 7 letters in Washington. He found out that out in New York, you get 8 letters because there's so many people out in New York. And so it's flat was already taken by somebody else. So he used all 8 letters and said, it is flat. And there's been a whole bunch of people from different states that have been coming up with different variations. One of my favorite new ones, which I can't wait to see the picture for, is No Curve, because that's 7 letters. Usually get 6 or 7 or 8. And that includes the Canadian provinces. So if you, and I've already done 2 slideshows for those license plates, if you want me to display it, You can send me a pic of your license plate. You can also take the screenshot when it gets reserved, because the license, if you do it online, the your state may send you a screenshot of what it's going to look like before you get it. If you want to send me that before you get your plates, I'm happy to include it in my slideshows and my thumbnails and whatever else I can. I think it's a really, really cool way to express yourself and put it out there. Plus, it's going to confuse a whole bunch of drivers. And you might get some people to say, what is it about? And, you know, you can play coy. It's really, really cool. But thank you, Mark T. from New York, for showing me the plate. And I think I used his thing in today's slideshow as well as others. Matthew writes, hey, Mark, my name is Matt Farrell. I live in Netherlands and work in Boulder as a financial planner. I've been watching your YouTube channel. I have to say my eyes are open to what's really going on for a while. Unfortunately, most people I know are not able to see what's going on. I feel like I'm living in the Twilight Zone. Yeah, you and me both, man. If you have any time, I'd really like to meet up for some coffee or a couple beers to pick your brain. Please let me know if you are open to that. Thanks, Matt Farrell from Netherlands. And yeah, normally I would, man, but I left Colorado a couple years ago now. Well, not a couple years, a year and change. And I am now in Victoria, Canada. So, and I split my time between Victoria, Canada and Whidbey Island, Washington, where my family is. So sorry, I'm not in Colorado anymore. I was in Colorado for 20 years, but not now. So thank you for reaching out, though. It's wonderful. And hey, if I ever get back to Colorado, who knows, maybe I'll set up some sort of flat earth mixer out there. This one's from Andrew. I'm Andrew Montez, and I would like your take on the Northern Lights and what causes them. No freaking idea what causes the Northern Lights, other than it is part of the system. No different than the stars in the sky and the comets and all the other fun stuff you see up there. It is part of the display system. I do not know what they are using to project it, but it is not what they say, you know, where the Earth is flying through space and it is the cosmic wind or the solar winds bouncing off the magnetic field of the North Pole. I know it's not that. So thank you for that. This one's from Latik, L-A-T-I-Q, last name Q-U-R-E-S-H-I. Dear Mr. Sargent, I watch your video with great interest. You make a compelling case for a creator. I agree that there is a creator. My question is, why do the hundreds, if not thousands of people since 1956 that are part of the authority that are covering up the truth of our world not afraid of the creator? I think they are, but maybe they were told that the creator isn't as dire as and judgmental as, you know, maybe God was downplayed. Or the creators were downplayed. That's what I'm hoping. Why is that no one or no group have come forward to expose the deception? Who are you going to come forward to? Exactly. Who, you know, mainstream media is controlled by the authority. Who, it's, if you had the evidence right now, other than social media, could you go anywhere? Could you go to the New York Times? Could you go to CNN? Could you go to NBC? Could you go to another country? I mean, mainstream media is pretty much locked down. You're not going to walk into Anderson Cooper's office, slap down some pictures or some evidence and say, run the story. He's not going to be able to do it. He's got to go to his producers, and his producers have to answer to other producers and eventually work their way up to the top. This is not, if it comes out of mainstream media, it's for, there's going to be an ulterior motive there. And why is the, to me, this does not make any sense, as you rightfully suggest that most, if not all, who know the truth would be afraid to commit perjury. I will wait to hear your response to my questions. Thanks and best wishes, Latik. Thanks, Latik. And again, a common question, but I hear it a lot. Let's see here. Chuck writes, okay, I've enjoyed your videos. One I've seen lately gave validity to nuclear weapons. So you really believe they are real? Yes, I do. I'm a big explosive buff and a ballistics buff, and anything goes boom or weapon technology in general. It's one of my hobbies that I've kind of dabbled in for years and years. And at the very least, the atomic weapon test, you can say what you want, but you know, there were special effects, but go ahead and look back and watch Trinity and Beyond, which was narrated by Bill Shatner. Look, our special effects technology was utter crap back in the 40s and 50s. And even into the early 60s, it was not very good. There was no CGI there. Some of those explosions are very, very good. Now, you want to say they're not fission explosions, fine. That's but we all know radiation exists. If you didn't, then if you don't believe that radiation exists, fine. Go into a dentist's office, try to have an x-ray taken. without the lead blanket. Try it. Radiation exists. So the question is, if radiation exists, why isn't fission possible? I do believe in fission. I do. Other people, if they don't, they don't. That's fine. But I do believe there are very, 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 very powerful explosives. If you don't want to think they are atomic based, fine. You don't have to think that. But if we are made up from energy and the bonds of those energy, the energy connections in our bodies and other things can be broken, and you can find an element that is weak enough, you can break those bonds and it releases massive amounts of energy, and those masses can react other masses, you can create critical mass, then why wouldn't it be possible? So anyway, you'll probably be interested in researching it. Some Jesuit priests lived close to the zero point in Hiroshima and suffered no ill effect. Official videos after it dropped show concrete structures near the zero point still standing. Yes, that's true. But you gotta remember, that was a 20 kiloton weapon. That's only 20,000, I know we're saying this, 20,000 tons of TNT or dynamite. The equivalent of taking 20,000 trucks that can hold a ton, pack them to the gills with dynamite and setting them off. That's the sort of type of explosive we're talking about. 20,000 of them. Does not even compare to those. Remember, those are the early versions. Now we had to invent a term called megaton, which is million tons. And there's, the biggest burst, if you believe it, in the Russians was a 50 megaton weapon. So yes, I believe in it. So sorry. So if you look for videos on YouTube, just search Hiroshima hoax. I'd be interested to see what you think after. No, I believe atomic weapons are real. I do. There's some things but I don't. Am I going to get into a long debate about it with people about it? No, I'm not, because flat Earth trumps all these things. So, and does it really matter if find me a motivation for creating a really good motivation for creating whatever that nuclear weapons are not real. Find me the motivation for faking it. A good one, really good one. Not just an average one. Kind of like when I thought that the Apollo missions were faked, but I couldn't figure out why. Because one of the early reasons is, well, you're doing this for national pride, rah rah, go USA, wave the flag. It was a pretty good reason, but it wasn't great. Only when Flat Earth came along did I understand. It's like, you didn't fake the moon missions because you wanted to. You faked them because you had to. So anyway, thank you for bringing that up. Let's see here. Tom writes, "Hi Mark, this is a video that will blow you away. You must watch the last part of it. Keep it flat. Regards, Tom." So I'm clicking on it, and it says air crash investigation 2016, Air Asia flight 850 with disaster over Indonesia." Sorry, hang on, the fan's running. Hi, Victoria, and the furnace happens to be really close to here. So yeah, thank you. Send me any links you want. I will at least open them. Let's see here. Chris Pontius, detail about how he built his models. And so if anyone wants a physical model of the Flat Earth, I'm not going to read the detail here. They are not cheap. I will save this, but they are very nice models. You can email Chris Pontius, who makes the Flat Earth models, and you can see a video of them. To send it to Flatten It. So FLATTINIT at gmail.com, and he will send you a form email which describes in great detail how he made his Flat Earth models. Moving on. How much time I got? I still got 10 more minutes. Chase writes. Let's Chase writes, "Mr. Sargent, I would like to share with you my latest experience with telling another person about the Flat Earth theory. A coworker of mine was tracking a flight that his son was taking from Germany to Atlanta. He was mentioning how the plane was going up past the United Kingdom. Then it was doing what looked like a large U-turn that brought them near Greenland. Finally, it started going south down the East Coast towards Atlanta. My coworker mentioned that even though he understood the principle of planes staying close to land, that it seemed like they could have just cut across the North Atlantic and saved time and fuel. That's when I woke up. I reminded him of my flight from Atlanta to Tokyo and how the plane tracker seemed to show a similar U-turn going up past Alaska, then back toward Japan. Then I reminded him of how on the AE map the path was almost straight. So I got him to pull up the AE map, and wouldn't you know, that U-turn became only a slight bend. My coworker still has his objections, but was less dismissive than before. I want this to be an encouragement to my flat earth friends. Ah, T. Just think of the globe as a large stone. Sure, we could take a sledgehammer and break it apart. But with a smaller hammer, a tiny chisel, and some patience, we can create something much more beautiful. Thank you again for being a public voice for this movement. Chase. P.S. I started a Facebook page called Flat Earth South Carolina. I hope to turn it into a forum for people who live in and near the state to discuss how we can share Flat Earth with others and as a hub for the Flat Earth info. So if anyone wants to join up, look it up. It's called Flat Earth South Carolina. Thank you, Chase. Very positive. Gretchen sends an email and says, hi and happy new year. I watched and thoroughly enjoyed your video and others on the same topic. I have grappled with telling people the truth about things since I was a child. Very early, I began explaining to my fifth grade class in 1971 about chemicals and food dyes in their food, moving on to junior high, talking about a drug-free healthcare system, and finally becoming an alternative healthcare practitioner and trying to help people see their own responsibilities in their daily choices, hoping to empower them. It's puzzling to me, but vaccinations, it's still a very tough issue to crack no matter how much evidence there is to dispel the theory of their safety and efficiency. It seems like I've been scratching my head for a long time over what just feels like a stubborn desire to stay safe in the dark, which is why I took your message very seriously when you said there were others, people who want to force the reset. You have 500 members? I would love to know more. Sincerely, Dr. Gretchen M. Silver. And I'm not exactly sure what she's talking about, the 500 members. There's a lot of people in Flat Earth. Hopefully she's listening to this. And again, you know, I love the fact that some different conspiracy people are getting involved in Flat Earth. It opens your mind to just about everything, and it makes you revisit just about every other conspiracy you can think of. Rick J. writes, Antarctic support employees. Hi, Mark. First of all, thanks for the work you've done and continue to do. You're definitely saved a lot of people, including myself, a lot of effort and energy. Of course, you're not the only source of credible information, but you are the only one who has made your contact information so publicly available. Now to the point. I don't know whether it would be useful to speak with anyone that actually worked in Antarctica on the civilian side. I'm not sure they know anything that would advance the Flat Earth belief or not. Maybe. Just thinking out loud, I find it hard to believe they don't know something whether they realize it or not. Given the compartmentalization, the powers that be used to keep one hand from knowing that the other what the other is doing. There's more to this story than I care to type here, but if you think it's worth pursuing or want more details, feel free to call me at your convenience. I can talk a heck of a lot faster than I can type. Yeah, me too. With all the robocalls nowadays, I don't usually answer numbers I don't recognize, so if you're calling from another other than my number, shoot me an email or text message. Warm regards, Rick Jenkins. Thanks, Rick. And yeah, if I get some time, I will try to reach out to some more people. It's just been so tough because I get swamped with a whole bunch of emails and phone calls. This one is called Coast to Coast AM Radio. Dear Mark, I was so impressed with your video on YouTube and your appearance with George Norrie on May 25th, 2015. Ah, there we go, May 21st, 2015. You have a voice for radio. I wish George would hire you to fill in for him on the show. He is always looking for broadcasters to fill in for him. Maybe you could talk to George's producer, Lisa or Tom, to see what they think. You have quite a voice and intelligence. Your mother must be proud. I'm seriously considering your theory on the flat earth. I remember a broadcast of Admiral Byrd saying, "The world is not what we think." Does the Bermuda Triangle or black holes have anything to do with the flat earth? Black holes, no. Bermuda Triangle, not necessarily directly related to Flat Earth, but I do think it's part of an older civilization that is currently now the Atlantic Ocean that's out there. It could be some old tech that's down there, you know, but nobody's talking, you know, we're not going to find the answers anytime soon, probably when this world finally comes to a close. As far as me doing any substitutes for George Norrie, that's very, very flattering, but you know, if somebody wants to contact Lisa, his producers, Lisa or Tom, and say, hey, you know, maybe you should talk to Mark Sargent. Hey, I'd be happy to do it. I hope that I don't get roped into not being able to talk about things. George Norrie, for example, along with Joe Rogan and Alex Jones, absolutely will say up front that he believes everything involved in NASA. He believes in all sorts of conspiracies, but he also thinks that NASA is completely legit. So I don't think I could do the show if I was told I had to it would be impossible. I couldn't do both. But yeah, happy to do it if anyone asks me. So I try not to solicit myself out there. So if anyone wants to contact them on my behalf, more power to you. How much time do we got? We got a few minutes left. I think we can crank out a couple more. And we'll call this one good. This one's from Kevin. Hi, Mark. I will be brief. Have for a long time believed that our government continually lies. For me, 9/11 was the greatest cover-up that turned me to exploring other things such as flat Earth. My question is, if our telescopes supposedly can see galaxies back in time billions of years, why can we not see the dome or whatever is limiting us from getting out? Just wondering. By the way, great job on the video I watched. Thanks, Kevin Detler from South Dakota. And yeah, Kevin, good point. They're looking, I think they're looking into the firmament if they're not just manufacturing the images entirely. You can't see the dome because, well, you're inside the dome. If you go into a planetarium with a pair of binoculars and you look at Jupiter, does Jupiter look more or less real? It doesn't really matter because you're looking at an image that makes you think there's a sphere up there called Jupiter. And you say, well, it's just because you're in a planetarium. Again, my argument is when you walk out of the planetarium, who's to say that you're not in just a bigger version of it? NASA? The Americans? It's a lot of faith. This one's from, who's this one from? Smiley Face. Literally, they signed it Smiley Face. Hey, Mark, I became a flat earther about 4 months ago. The first week I heard the world is flat, I watched YouTube videos and looked stuff up online hours a day. I was hooked. I ran into some questions. What is the cause of the change in stars and the night sky, like for the different seasons? It's just how it's programmed. It's the patterns in the night sky. It's not going to run the same way every night. That's the beauty of it. It's the little details. Again, remember in the early versions of this world, if you believe the old text, there was no sun. There was no moon. But as different versions, as things, you know, get better, evolve, I hate to use that word too much, you put in more details to inspire people. And stars, it's not just you have stars moving across the sky in the same patterns. You change it up. It works really, really well. My mother takes trips to North Dakota coming from the south. She says she can see the curvature of the earth going north on US 81. Uh-huh. Is there a way for people to make the landscape look curved? No. Have her take a picture. I put the challenge out there at least a year and a half ago now, and nobody's done it. Nobody's proved me wrong. And that is, you think you see the curvature of the earth from a beach or a flat plane or in a real plane or whatever, take a picture of it. Put it on your laptop or whatever, hold a straight edge up to it, and tell me if the curve's still there. If it is, send it to me at msargent23@comcast.net, and I will give up flat earth forever, as long as you're not using a fisheye lens, of course. On videos, people did laser tests at sea level to another location at sea level. There it was no curvature. Absolutely true. I saw something on YouTube. It talked about if we only see space during nighttime sky, how come we can see Mercury and Venus? We would have to see through past the sun and the blue atmosphere on the daytime side of the earth to see those planets. He opened my eyes so wide, it was like something that was right in front of me, and I did not put one and one together. We are seeing planets on the opposite side of the earth, out of order planets. More flat earth evidence versus spinning ball from Smiley Face. Thank you, Smiley Face. And I'm not going to give away your email, even though it's right there in front of me. How much time? Can we do one more? I think so. Hello, thanks for your videos. I have no scientific knowledge, but I was always suspicious of NASA. To this day, I don't know why they don't land on the moon anymore. I suspect it's because it would be more difficult to scam a technologically advanced citizen. Yes, absolutely right. I'm going to read the Bible again to see if there's anything there that can argue stronger for one theory or the other. Regards, Ken. And I will send him an email, and we will wrap that up on this show. But to answer the perfect points here to end the show on, which is, yes, it is so tough to fake stuff now because the detection ability of the general public has gotten so much more advanced. You can't fake a Mars mission now. No one's going to Mars anyway. You can talk about it all you want. You're just going to kick that can down the road forever, kind of like they did with hydrogen fuel cell cars. Remember those? Nobody's talking about those anymore. We've gotten way better at detecting things. I would be scared to death to try to fake a space program right now of any size. And as far as going to read the Bible again, hey, you don't have to. All the work's already been done for you. Go to testingtheglobe.com, which is done by Rob Skiba, and it'll give you all the cool references for it. So anyway, thank you guys very, very much. All the people that have written in so far. Again, if I don't read them on a Q&A show, I will try to squeeze them in during Strange World episodes, which are currently Tuesday nights on Truth Frequency Radio. Although I get so many phone calls now during Strange World, I hardly get any emails at all. And again, do you want to email me your email? And if it's interesting and relatively polite, send it to msargent23@comcast.net. And if you also want to check out my YouTube channel, which is Mark K. Sargent, or just go into any search engine and type in Flat Earth Clues. That'll take you there. So thank you very much, guys, and we'll see you next time.